National Football League is on the air.
The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. A clash of two of the more fervent fan bases around. The Cowboys and the Raiders are underway. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Prescott on first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away.
And this is dropped. Oh, boy. A chance for a big play early, but he could not secure it.
Intended that time for Cooper. That'll bring up second down. About the 29, just shy of the 30. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline. But out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now Prescott. And here's the former Raider wideout, Amari Cooper. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 19 yards that time for number 19. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 48-yard line. To throw is Prescott. And down he goes, brought down a Raider sack.
Well, remember, they had the nice gain on the previous play, but they just gave a lot of it back right there on that sack.
Yeah, they get the sack, get back some real estate. Felt like the type of play that can spark a defense and swing some momentum. Almost felt like a take that type of a play, didn't it, partner?
Throwing on second and long. Prescott. Under pressure again, and down he goes again.
Now make that a second sack here on their first drive out defensively, and not to get ahead of ourselves, but they're on pace for double-digit sacks at this point.
But they're going to have to find a way to tamp that down, aren't they? So if you're the play caller, you're telling your quarterback maybe some screens, maybe some draws, hard count, use your voice inflection a little bit, anything to try and slow that pressure.
Now into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked up by Nate Hobbs.
And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, their turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that.
Thank you.
Here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well. That interception early, they may rethink how they go about attacking.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
So, Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath. Maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
Trying to run for it with Jacobs.
Yeah, boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. They'll run. It's Drake. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Heck of a fourth and short conversion. They end up getting north of 20 yards.
On their own side of the field. Close to the 50, but their own side of the field. They only needed a couple of inches, and they were able to get it done.
And it doesn't matter whether you're a zone-blocking team, a man-blocking team, gap-blocking, whatever you want to call it. When it's in this situation, it's really man on man, isn't it? Who's going to win?
And he's in.
Touchdown, Raiders.
32 yards. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. Well, a lot of things have to go right for an option pitch to be successful. Everything lined up there on the long run.
It does, because you have to make the proper read. It doesn't matter what guy you've decided is going to be read on the defensive front. You still have to execute it. If he comes to the quarterback, you saw there, pitch it out to the running back, and off he goes. A lot of teams don't like to run the option because they don't like having their quarterback hit.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Carlson now to kick this one away. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Connects here with a tight end, Blake Jarwin. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards. It moves the sticks from all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Prescott from the gun. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line.
I don't think there's anyone who could possibly doubt how fast he could run in the open field. But if there were, he silenced those thoughts there. Elliott.
Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up 2nd and goal.
Again, it's Elliott.
And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a 3rd down. Prescott to throw it.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Able to get there and pick it. He's at the 50. The 30. Past the 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a
Raiders!
Short throw, pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this one.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early. to let him get settled back in.
But they told us they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. First catch for him on the afternoon, and it results in a first down. Here's Prescott. Wide open, Amari Cooper. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 10 more there and another first down. They'll throw again. Prescott. This to Jarwin. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. That goes for a gain of 31. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Now Prescott. For the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Blake Jarwin there to make the grab. And the Cowboys draw a bit closer. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to drop those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But if you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. It worked out for six. And he returns this to the 22. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And still plenty of time remaining here in the half, more than a minute. And we'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine it would be the latter. I think they're going to try and add on to it. So what they're going to tell the team is very simply, if you can get out of bounds after making a play downfield, terrific. If you can't, everyone hustle to the line of scrimmage, either run another play or clock it and start over again.
So the field flips here as they'll go to work at the 20 now on first and 10. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jacobs. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. First throw now for the backup Carr. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Well, this was a 14-0 game not too long ago. Things were looking pretty good. Then you give up the touchdown on the last drive. Now the interception.
So that's a lesson in trying to stay vigilant, isn't it? You have to stay on top of things. Can't relax too much because, as you noted, things change. Now they've got to go out there and get a spark going again and try and slow down this comeback.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. And the Raiders have got him. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
Both teams making their final adjustments before we get started once again. And for the call of the second half, let's send you back out to Allegiant Stadium and Brandon God.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Raiders with the lead already, and they will get the football here as the second half is now underway. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive.
A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, you have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
They go back to the ground, this time Jacobs. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. And that time, the tackle by Malik Hooker. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. On play action, now Carr. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Throwing now is Carr. Oh, looking for Waddle, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
Escapes the defender, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 45 yards rushing for him now on just six carries to this point. Play action now, Prescott. He'll fire this deep for Gallup. And this is caught. And he almost made it, but just short. Finally out of bounds, right down around the goal line. After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal.
Dak going to hand it to Elliott on the option.
And he is not going to get through here on try number one. They stop him at the goal line. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal. Throwing, Prescott to the end zone, but it's incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, but now it's third and goal.
Now we got third and goal coming up, and couldn't you imagine being in that huddle, partner? You know they're looking at each other saying, we can't come away with just 3 points after this drive.
Yeah, they've covered a lot of ground. They want more than that three.
Zeke going to get it on the option.
And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott punching it in from a yard away. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that will tie our game here in the third. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Now a carry for Jacobs. The football comes out. Jacobs lost it. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And at this stage in the game, sure, you wanted the touchdown. You're already in the red zone. But, boy, you squandered a chance to at least get the field goal there. So no points out of this, and we stay tied.
Very disappointed team. No one more disappointed than the kicker who thought he had a chance to be the hero of the day. All they had to do is trot him out on the field. They didn't even give him the opportunity.
Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. From the shotgun, a give to Elliott.
And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
On third down, it's Prescott. Completes it right side to Cooper. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A strong pickup of 11 keeps their drive alive. Gonna take a shot for Gallup. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. Off the play fake, Prescott. Outright completes it to Jarwin. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. 10th carry now for Elliott. Elliott a first down and more. And finally down at the 32-yard line. 71 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 32-yard line. He'll fire this deep for Gallup, and this is incomplete. Oh, that looked like a sure 6 points, but he could not get that to stick, and that is a golden opportunity wasted there. A second down throw for Prescott. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Merrick. And he will take it across midfield and down to the 45. Well, we say it often, Charles, but not all interceptions are created equally, and that is a big one here in a tie ball game in the fourth quarter.
And, Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes, and that was one of our mantras back at Tennessee. Coach Major say all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Now a play fake, Carr. He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. And that is caught. Touchdown!
Touchdown!
And most people think of Derek Carr as a guy who excels throwing the short pass. But he can dial it up when need be.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield. And you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Casey Hayward. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes his forward for about 6.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training.
There he goes, right side. The 20. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Jacobs. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal.
This is where coaches have to have spent a lot of time going over situations with their players, because him getting tackled there is not the worst thing in the world. You're going to run more plays, right? Clock's going to go. But his thought process is getting into the end zone. It's counterintuitive for him to actually go down in this spot.
Yeah, but you, like you say, you don't want to get in the end zone too early here.
No, not at all, because you may leave an opening that could come back and get you.
It's a loss of two, now third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. Third and goal. It's Drake. And he'll take it into the end zone.
Touchdown, Raiders!
Goodbye.